Dear students, in this lecture, we are going to see how RNA has been functioned as a genetic material from the primitive time. And then we are going to see how DNA is functioning as a genetic material. For that, they have conducted some different types of experiments. We are going to look at those experiments, say Griffith experiment. That is the one which shows that the process of transformation aids in transfer of a hereditary trait from one generation to another generation, identifying the transforming principle of the DNA, that is McCarthy experiments, which we are going to see in detail. And the third one is the Hershey and Chase experiment. The Hershey and Chase experiment proved that the genetic material transfer is effected through the process of transduction involving the bacteriophages. And we are also having one called conjugation, which I have marked there in the blue color, as it's an assignment. You can prepare the answer related to conjugation by yourself, and you can get it signed from me in the course journal. Now we look at into the points related to how RNA has been functioning as a genetic material. So this is a image showing from the time of earth formation to diversification of the life. So during this course of evolution, at some part of the time, the RNA has been serving as a genetic material there. So this is the formation of Earth, and a stable hydrosphere has been established there. During the time, the probiotic chemistry process have been started. What is a probiotic chemistry process? It's a formation of certain important biomolecule or biological building blocks in a de novo process. Say for example, amino acids, sugars, nucleosides. They are all started forming there at that particular stage. Okay. Then the next stage involves a formation of RNA. So the first genetic material that has been present there in the primitive world is only RNA, and it's not DNA. We will look at later what is the reason behind replacement of RNA with the DNA as a genetic material. So here, RNA has started evolved during the very earlier period of the Earth evolution. The RNA formed there has been a self-replicating RNA, and they are also having certain catalytic function. That is, they can able to function like an enzyme. So the RNA that have been formed there later resulted in the RNA template based translation process. That is, it resulted in the protein synthesis formation of, as I already told, the RNA is the one which has been replaced there with the DNA during the later period of the evolution. And from there, the replication of the DNA molecules have started, and the process of transcription, then the translation and protein synthesis are all initiated from that particular phase also. The later stage is the one in which a lot of horizontal gene transfer events have been occurring. The horizontal gene transfer events are those in which the genetic material has been exchanged between two different organisms. Three important horizontal gene transfer events occurring in the living organisms are transformation, transduction, and conjugation. We will try to see in detail about the transformation as well as transduction in the subsequent lectures. Now we will look at the experiments and scientists associated with RNA as a genetic material. That is, what are the experiments conducted to prove that RNA as a genetic material? Here, the important scientists are Gehrer and Schramm, who has showed that tobacco mosaic virus like lesion could be formed when the tobacco mosaic plants are inoculated with the purified RNA that has been obtained from the tobacco mosaic virus. So you can able to see the structure of the tobacco mosaic virus and the type of disease that have been shown there in the right hand side. Another experiment in which the proof for RNA as a genetic material was obtained, it was actually conducted by Heinz, Frankel, Conrad as well as B. Singer. So they have used two different kinds of viruses to prove that RNA can serve as a genetic material. They have taken tobacco mosaic virus and HR virus, that is Holmes ribgrass virus. So these are the two different kinds of viruses which causes some diseases there on the tobacco plants. So with that, they are able to prove that the genetic material has been present there only in the RNA. They demonstrated that RNA acts as a genetic material by using the Tobacco mosaic virus that causes a mottling disease on tobacco plants, and HR virus that is Holmes ribgrass virus that causes a distinct ring pattern like disease on the tobacco plants. That is two different viruses that causes two different diseases has been taken there as a model to prove the nature of RNA as a genetic material. So first one is the tobacco mosaic virus, which has been subjected for degradation of the protein. That is, tobacco mosaic virus protein is degraded by using certain enzymes. As a result, you are able to see only the tobacco mosaic virus RNA. Then the second one here is the HR virus. So HR virus has been taken. Again, it is subjected for degradation of their protein coat. Why they are subjected for degradation of protein coat is, both these viruses are having only two important structure. One is the outer one protein coat, and the inner one is a nucleic acid that is made up of RNA. So again, this HR virus also, the protein coat has been degraded by using the enzyme, and they are able to reconstitute a hybrid virus. Okay, so this is a reconstituted hybrid virus. By just looking at the thing itself, we can able to understand it has been reconstituted with the protein coat of the HR virus and the nucleic acid, that is RNA of the tobacco mosaic virus. Okay, this reconstituted hybrid virus is now allowed to infect the tobacco plants. Okay, so these are the symptoms caused by the these viruses on the leaves. Okay, further they are showing the symptoms there. So this reconstituted virus, which is made up of protein coat of the HR virus and the RNA of the tobacco mosaic virus, is allowed to infect the tobacco plants. So as a result, you are able to see what type of disease there is. Only a tobacco mosaic virus kind of disease, or the viral progeny that have been obtained there after the infection of the reconstituted virus is mainly of a tobacco mosaic virus. So that is the one explained here. The progeny viruses that are all formed after the infection of a new leaf with a reconstituted hybrid virus reflects the RNA source that is the one which has been present in the reconstituted hybrid virus. That is, protein is not the one which dictates the hereditary information. However, the genetic material, that is RNA that have been present there, is the one which is dictating the hereditary information. So this experiment has very clearly proved that RNA can able to act as a genetic material. Now we will look at one more small experiment that has been conducted by Pace and Spiegelman. They have used a purified RNA that has been obtained from two different mutant strains of RNA phage, Cubetta. Cubetta, that is the name of the phage. The isolated RNAs were then incubated separately in the presence of E. coli cell. The extract containing an enzyme capable of a RNA replication, that is E. coli extract found to have enzyme that is capable of replication of the phage RNA. The new RNA synthesized in each case was identical to the base composition of a particular phage RNA only. It indicates that the phage RNA is the one which serves as a template for its self-replication and formation of the new progeny. Some of the common RNA viruses and their types of RNA has been mentioned here. Tobacco mosaic virus is a plant virus made up of a single stranded RNA. Influenza virus, Rouse sarcoma virus, and Rouse sarcoma virus is the one which is commonly present there in the animals. They are all commonly made up of a single stranded RNA. Even the coronavirus is being coming under the single stranded RNA viruses. Then rhinoviruses is again an animal virus, but it is made up of a double stranded RNA. MS2, F2, R17, they are all certain bacteriophage related viruses, that is viruses which affects the bacteria. They are all found to have single stranded RNA as their genetic material. Now we will look at into an important topic, that is, you all understood that in the early environment it was only RNA that was acting as a genetic material. But why the RNA has been replaced with the DNA as a genetic material in most of the organisms? Say they are being present, RNA is being present as a genetic material only among the viruses. Whereas if you look at into the human system, our plant system, animal system, fungal system, even bacteria, they are all having the DNA as a genetic material. Why? There could be some important valuable reasons. These reasons we are going to see in this particular lecture. Now we look at the reason why the RNA has been replaced with the DNA. The DNA double helix is more stable than an RNA double helix, as the DNA lacks a reactive OH group at the second carbon position. If you look at into the RNA, you can able to see a reactive OH group. So this group is highly reactive. So as a result, that molecule may not be more stable. However, if you look at into the DNA molecule, the second carbon position, you are having only a hydrogen, which makes that molecule to be more stable. This is one reason. The second reason, DNA contains thymine, which is a more stable and it basically a methylated form of uracil. So this is a thymine. Thymine is the one which is similar to that of the uracil, whereas a methyl group is present in addition to that of the uracil molecule. So thymine has a greater resistance to photochemical mutation, making the genetic messages to be more stable. That is, uracil is present only in the RNA, whereas it has been replaced with the thymine in the DNA. We will look at now some more additional points. Say for example, they are saying cytosine, which has been present at the cell, can be easily converted into a uracil molecule. The reason is cytosine can be deaminated, which results in the formation of a uracil molecule. This is a common reaction that happens around 100 times per cell in a day. So, thus a G plus C base pairing will be altered or converted into AT base pairing due to the mutation, that is conversion of cytosine to uracil. So, this is a problem there with that of the uracil molecule. Now, we look at another point that also substantiates why the DNA is serving as a genetic material. Uracil forms a stable hydration product which could not be repaired. That is, when uracil is subjected to photooxidation, that is with the UV light, it can be converted into a highly stable photohydration product. This particular product cannot be easily repaired. However, if you look at there into the DNA molecule, it forms into a dimerized product called as a thymine dimer. Okay. So this thymine dimer will be resulted due to the action of UV on the DNA molecule. But this thymine dimer can be partially photoreversed. That is, it can be converted into normal thing when it is subjected for a photoreactivation mechanism. So this is a mechanism which is easily possible by irradiation at a relatively longer wavelength of lights. This kind of process may not be of a much effective in converting the uracil stable hydration product into a normal uracil. That is, the uracil dimer which forms due to UV action on it cannot be converted into normal form. However, thymine dimer that is formed due to the action of UV can be photoreversed. That is, it can be converted into normal thymine molecules with the help of a long wavelength of white light. So these are the reasons which says that thymine that have been present there in the DNA is playing an important role there to the stability of the DNA molecule.